gods of Asgard are noble and free. They're upright and forthright as great gods should be. But there's one in their midst, doesn't follow the rule. That sly mischief-monger called Loki the Fool. He lies and he pilfers, tells jokes that are crude. He's raucous, he's ribald, he's rowdy, he's rude. He tricks and he teases, though he's not really cruel. Just don't turn your back on that Loki the Fool. In grim Jotunheim, where the weather is freezin', he mixed blood with Odin, and who knows the reason? They laughed and drank wine, went on gay escapades, fought wizards and trolls, and seduced fair young maids. Now some think that hero Odin made a mistake by tying himself to this impudent rake. But I'll tell you a fact, though it makes scholars mad. If the Allfather likes him, he can't be all bad. Poor Lot's reputation is not of the best. He gave Sif a clip job without her behest. He lifted from Freya her most precious jewel, and Thor's got his hands full when he rides with the fool. He stole Idun's apples, which wasn't too nice, side monsters galore, and put Balder on ice. And the gods all berate him for what he has done. Well, gee, can a boy have a wee bit of fun? They say he's corrupted and wicked indeed, 'cause he mothered the Allfather's whimsical steed. It's not he's perverted or easily led, let's just say he's not very choosy in bed. He tried to enliven sedate Asgard's halls by tying the beard of a goat to his balls. And they say that his tongue's his most effective tool, and that's why all the ladies love Loki the Fool. To the end of all time he'll roam free through the land, and all things stir and change at the touch of his hand. And when the world's old and no fun's left in store, he'll blow it all up and start over once more. Now scholars and such say he's captured and bound, but just look at the world, you'll see he's still around. For to live here without